Can attack. Alright, we're in. Welcome to Negative Cube. My first Negative Cube. Our first Negative Cube. Let's see what we can do here. Window resizing. As always. Alright, so this is a new cube which features only cards that are not in other cubes on Magic Online. What do we have?
We need to read a lot of cards today.
We are gonna have to read a lot of cards. Oh, the 6-6 flying, where as long as it's on the battlefield you can't win. Godsend equipment. When the creature gets blocked or blocks, you can exile one of those, +3/+3. And your opponents cannot cast spells. That's actually a pretty good card. +3/+3 equipment.
The dragon is also good, right?
Angel Despair, attrition, that's pretty good. Black has some sort of sacrifice theme.
I kind of like the dragon because it's basically colorless.
Alright, let me see all the other cards. Can I draw a target creature or survive 3 and then... Alright, that's pretty cool. Incubation Druid, Mana Fixer.
Yeah,
Maul is
nice.
Also very good. Colorless dragon. Calculator. Okay, time is running out.
Druid or dragon?
Yeah, druid or dragon. Let's take the druid. I like many cards, but I do like being in green and green X, like having the option to play any color. Dude, there's a lot of equipment. Green, red, dual land, petty teeth, ooh la la. Well, it's a 5/5 flying for 6. It's a Talpa. Culling Dice. Sacrifice a creature, it's a charge counter. Sacrifice it, you draw a card for each. Okay, so red black cast is like make a bunch of small creatures and sacrifice them or something. Ready 1/1 and attach it. Alright, that's pretty cool.
I do like a rich scale tasker.
Oh, that's pretty good. Yeah, not sure in this format.
Yeah.
We could just pick the green card. Rain is also good. Instant speed, rather pretty good card draw. Okay, the flying splicer. So blue, white, green has this whole blink theme, as far as I know. I think we're taking the Tusker.
I think we can't pull
it. It even combos with the druid. If it has one counter, you get 3 mana.
How many counters does it get when it adapts 3?
When some creatures attack, you get 2 mana, that's pretty neat. Probably can be like green-red, some sort of stompy. Locust God is 6 mana, but those gods are pretty good. Like Scarab God in Vintage Cube is extremely good, and now we could take this card. It does make tokens, which works well with this.
Right, it is a reasonable removal spell.
Yeah, that's good, that's true. You can make anything into
anything,
a forest.
Yeah.
But this is kind of a bomb, I think.
It's still kind of like a Path to Exile, it's anything.
Maybe the Meteor Golem, actually. That's also basically unconditional removal on a creature. I like that card.
We have 2 ETB effects already.
Yeah. I love me Mana Rocks. Precursor Golem makes 2 tokens and instant or sorceries then get copied onto every. So if you can blink this with non-instant or sorcery effects, it's pretty good. I honestly want to take the Talisman. I think Mana Rocks are very good.
Go ahead. We already have a 7 drop.
Exactly. 4 damage to any target for 4 mana. It's pretty good, actually. Yeah, I want to be like a Rampy, Stompy type deck, that seems like something I enjoy. Dude, you've been singing this song all day, this is your reward.
You know why I was?
Well, because I'm not entirely sure, but you build these things out of Lego from that game.
I had it in my Instagram video.
Makes sense. Draw 4 cards, sorcery speed. Roalesque, put 2 counters on another creature and when it dies you proliferate twice. And it's just a big flyer. Jinx, Choker, Temple, what does that do? Beginning of your end step target, no one has control of it. At the beginning of your upkeep, it is damage. Oh, it's that thing, I remember. Overgrowth.
I really like the flyer. It's 5 mana for 6-7 stats,
yeah.
Basically.
I'm not sure how many of these big bombs are in the cube. We've basically been seeing one. So, should you prefer ramp or bombs is the question, honestly.
And I think at this point I would take the flyers since we already have two ramp cards.
I'm kinda leaning towards the overgrowth. It ramps you for two. And I mean, maybe there's... What I'm trying to say is maybe there's more big things than ramp and you should prioritize it, maybe not. Body double copies any creature on the battlefield. What? No, only the graveyard. For 5. Okay, green is kinda not open. I like the mage. Radical idea. Wait, jumpstart is you discard any card, right? So... You may cast this card from a graveyard and... Oh, it gets exiled then, so it's not like that one thing where you can...
Is it a dark consideration or not?
Milikin. Maybe? I think I want the mage. It's like... Played on, what, turn 4? Have a body, find something else. It's pretty good. Oh, hell yeah. PSK Bluffs and Race Forerunners. Oh, yeah, that's basically the... What's his name?
That's our card.
What's his name again? Crater of Behemoth.
Yeah, mini Behemoth.
Also 8 mana. 7/7 and pumps everything for 2. I know what I want to do. I'll just pick mana dogs and shit. Not sure if there's similar effects to Prince Unseen Aether Natural Order in this cube. Maybe a Code of Calling or something. What else could there be? Eldritch Evolution, I'd love that card. Big fan. Alright, Pelaka Worm, nice.
What does Gigantha have?
Gigantha is... Well, you can basically... Okay, you have different mana costs on all card and then it ramps you. It's 5/5/5.
You're not allowed to have more than one colored mana symbol, right?
Oh, it's that thing, I read it wrong. Yeah. So we're already out from having this as companion, but...
What about Steel Hellkite?
Steel Hellkite is nice. Straight on turn in with mana cost X. That's pretty good. Worm is also nice. Here it is.
Go for the 6th drop.
Yeah, I agree. That seems pretty good. The dragon actually wheeled, nice. Maybe Gladkin Seer though is just something to play early, but it doesn't really fit the rest. Or the counter spell. The dragon's fine, but if you're not dreaded, it's very painful. I'm taking the counter spell. Have some more early plays. Not sure if this deck can leaf up the mana, we'll see. But it's already looking like my type of deck. For some reason I always end up in ramp. It's just somehow the easiest thing to do, right? You just pick the good things and the rampy cards.
Almost all our creatures have an ATP effect.
That's awesome, actually. So Vizier can blink something, right? Or you will take the Queen of the Fairies.
Not a fan of this card.
Well, it's a mana sink in the late game. It's what it is. Let's see if we can make use of that somehow. Plus 2 plus 0, First Strike, Vigilance, Trample and Haste. Grand Warlord Radar is basically ramp. Ramp or card draw. Do we wanna go into another color or just take the good card draw? Good with leaving up mana when you have multiple instants, I guess.
Also ramp and card draw go well together.
Sorcery draw 4,
yeah,
cycling.
I like that one.
It's basically we just saw the same card without cycling, right? Tidings. Or was it 5 mana?
I think there's a sorcery one for 5 mana.
Yeah, we saw Tidings. Is that the card I'm... Is it 5 or 6?
Probably the one you need.
Equipped warriors you control if double strike. I don't think we're doing that. So I'm probably not playing any of these. Yeah, I'm not sure about the white. Doesn't bear. Milikin wield. We do kinda like that. Alright, next pack. Archangel of Thune. Chaotic Prowler, Stranglerout, Geist, Orca Waste, Psy Memory Lapse. Time Walk in Rover Horror is pretty good. Not sure if we want to play another color, but it's a good card.
Mood could even be a consideration.
True.
I'm not sure.
I do like me mana fixing. Memory Lapse is nice. A reanimation spell, probably not Psy-ing. Another reanimation spell, dude.
Kinda like the Expanse.
Me too. The Drover Horror is also kind of amazing.
I think we're doing well on our top end.
Yeah. As I said, yeah, I think I was right with the... Ooh, there's a Garruk. I love me some Garruks. Those are Ronas. Reveal the top 5. And you had all creature cards in your hand. Put a green creature card from your hand onto the battlefield. I mean, he costs 6 mana and doesn't do that much. I'm not sure how good this card is, I've never seen him before. Alright, well, there's Ronas, Pathway. Epochracite is the thing that when it enters and you didn't cast it, it's bigger, so it's like a blink target, I guess. Meren's pretty good. Played in Legacy, actually. You can manifest the top card every turn and you can cast these cards. That's also not terrible. This is a Ronas deck.
I'm not sure.
Yeah, these gods are kind of hard to evaluate.
Maybe it's a Primordial Mist deck.
We could try the Garruk. He's like, if you play a lot of creatures, he's good card advantage. But are we?
I'm not sure.
Same. Let's take Ronas.
Ronas are right.
Scala is fine, Fairy Mechanist, this is like for artifact decks. Farin. Eldrazi Monument. Creatures you control, flying and indestructible, and you have to sack a creature every turn. Not really for the big creature thing, right? Probably also not doing that. Alright, so there is a lot of cards that work with small creatures and tokens.
In general, I like Farin, especially if we have some of the battlefield effects.
Yes, you could bounce your own things. Probably not a good... Probably not a very good Scatter the Seed stack. Yeah, we don't need anything else here. Nissa. Black-green Nissa Landfall. She gets a loyalty counter. Until we land, it becomes a 3-3 until end of turn. Input a creature card from your hand onto the battlefield, or from your graveyard. It's pretty good. Scar, Frost, Walker, Mind Shrieker. So there's a lot of these cheat creatures into play cards. I kinda wanna take the Planeswalker.
I also like the Scour All Possibilities, kind of.
Yeah, it's really slow, but it's pretty good. Not sure if we need that. We have a lot of double blue, so being 3 color could be hard. Okay, let's try that. It's basically a Preordain that's like slow but flashes back.
Ah, I like those effects.
Which ones?
Naturally. So I'm not sure about this format, but in general I love those effects.
Yeah.
4/4/5 that can get you a 2-for-1.
Yo, Doro!
Hello!
I kinda want the Wanderer, he could be so awesome in this deck.
He could try it.
Yeah. I also want the Mirror though. Like, that's a really good ramp.
Bye.
Champion of Ronas. There are so many of these cards that cheat stuff into play. Panharmonicon. Are we a Panharmonicon deck? Kind of. Dude, Duskwatch Recruiter is pretty nice, just good value.
Yeah.
How do I... Okay. Or just block a thing against the aggro deck. Tomb Raider is also not bad, but it's no Baleful Strix. Let's just wield the Panharmonicon. 4/4 flying for 4, Migration Path. Dude, I wanna play artifacts next time. There's so many artifact payoffs. Ooh, there we go, that's perfect for our deck, right? Just a big Planeswalker in our colors.
Notice in there.
Yeah, there's probably some Graveyard Shenanigans. We've seen a lot of Milieu,
What also, is the zero ability of the Nilsson?
You look at the top card, and if it's a land or creature that has fewer than her loyalty, then it become it's. You put it on the battlefield. That's pretty good. Nice. I think we're just staying green blue for now. Dude, yeah. Godot though. Nice.
Awesome card.
Have some. This is more for the slow matchups. I think this card's probably not good versus an aggro deck. Taints of the Manzi. Crafted Wargear. I do like Crafted Wargear. Not sure if we are gonna play it, but. No. So. No, I think we need a little bit more of the mid-range-y creature type cards, but there's another pack to go. I do like prioritizing my ramp. I think that's always a good idea. We have 5 ramp cards for now.
Yeah, and 2 that ramp us for 2 mana.
Yeah, no, actually there's 4, another.
3.
Frost Walker, Scrap Trawler, artifact stuff, not really. Yeah, you could play Frost Walker to block a thing against aggro, but not really that good.
What does the Frost Walker do again?
It's a phantasmal type effect.
For 1 for 2.
Yeah. Probably better in an aggro deck than here.
That memory lets out looks awesome.
Yeah. Not sure about these. I like Barin, but the double blue is kinda sketchy, also this card.
Yeah.
At 5 we should have it. I mean, countering something late game is nice. Check if it's a creature. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Yeah, there's some cool archetypes here. Black something, mill yourself type stuff, I guess. Artifacts in blue, black, maybe. It's looking like a fun deck, I love it. The Royal Science. Dismiss. Counter a spell draw card. Almost Cryptic Command, dude. 2 rampy effects. It makes a spawn. Grizzly Bear that makes a spawn. I'm leaning towards either Dismiss or the Sadia.
Take the Sadia.
Yeah. Maybe wield one of the counter spell effects. You are a 1 mana ramper though. Channeler initiate. So basically,
really
it's a 0-1 and it gets bigger and bigger. Yeah, but 1 drops though. I feel like.
But the other one makes any colors it fixes.
Mm.
I kind of like that one.
Still taking the 1 drop. 1 drops are so powerful. We're 2 color. It's fine. Maybe. Did we pass a lot of green blue lands? Or I think we saw the temple. Mm-hmm. Didn't get it back. On the 1 mana thing, splitting image. You're 6 mana though. It's a bit wild. Witching Whale, Real Smith. Beastmaster Ascension. We talked about this card before,
yeah,
right?
But I don't think we have the deck for
it. Yeah, probably not. Sacrifice any number of creatures and then you get all of the 3/2s. Yeah, Wild Growth. We're just the Crater Hoof deck now. Guardian Project. In a non-token creatures, you can draw a card. Except if you already have one. Top the Spy Network. If you control an artifact, so probably no. That gun's pretty good in green-red aggro. Haunted Plate Mail. It's 4/4 and you can make it into a 4/4 creature. If you control no creatures, interesting. I don't really see anything here. Card seems way too slow, also that, but whatever. Deprive Sphere of the Suns. Cloud Blazer, Winding Way. At this point, I don't want to splash white for that, even though it's an awesome card. Maybe another counter spell. Hunting Lance isn't really what you wanna do though. The sphere is like a ramp thing that ramps you 3 times. It's like... whatever. Green Warden of Murasa. When it enters, you get a land back. When it dies...
Any card, not a land.
Merchant target card. Yeah, it's pretty good. When it dies, also... Bruh.
Yo, yeah, awesome.
Arcbound Ravager is in the stack, Scholar of Lost Trove. You can cast an instant sorcery or artifact card from your graveyard. Without paying its mana cost.
I think the Green Warden is better.
Well, that gets your card back and then lets you recast.
But
well,
that gets you a card when it enters and when it dies.
We don't really have many instant or sorceries to play anyway. Like, we have some counter spells, you don't want to recast those. Yo, now our colors are so open. No, it's not a green blue lander. Singed Oracle, Apex Altisaur. 10-10. When it enters, it fights something. When it deals damage, it fights something else. See the unwritten reveal. The top 8.
That's basically 10 damage to everything.
You put a creature onto the battlefield and the rest in your hand. And if you have already a big thing, and you get 2. Pretty good.
The Altisaur basically fights the whole board of the opponent for 9 mana.
That's awesome.
It fights and fights again until it dies.
No, we do have a lot of ramp, so should we take
the
9 drop?
What is the 6 mana thing again?
You reveal the top 8 and you get 1 or 2 creatures. I'm gonna take that.
That's fine.
Sleep. This way. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Trading Post is like, probably we don't need that. Let's take the land slash spell. That's really good actually. Dismiss, counter spell, draw card. Nice, for spell. We win both of the counter spells. Let's take that one. Clint Nest Crane is an artifact thing. Enters tapped, doesn't untap as long as you have the reflection. So it's a 3-2 and then a 2-3. That's kind of me. This card's good if you have a lot of mana, which we do. Maybe. Probably not in the main deck though. Deck's looking wild. Not sure, but we don't really go wide, but I think the Tusk is still pretty good. Probably not playing that thing, it's really slow. Ronas, I think, is an odd. Emrakul's Evangel versus Witching Well. Don't really need any of these. Shrine of Loyal Leech is the white shrine, not for us.
Witching Well might be playable, actually.
I always love it when your colors are so open. So this gets us one of our 2 mana ramp spells. It's pretty cool actually. Slow, but it's value. Alright, so this is 27. 4 cuts from what we have here.
I don't think you want to play a 3 mana 2-2 that gets us a 2 drop.
It's not bad, but it's slow of course.
I don't think that's our path to victory.
So this is a land and... where's the other thing? There we go, this is also a land. So might cut the meat. Okay, so let's see this. And all of this, all of the counter magic. Might play some of them, but not all of them.
Yeah. What does the Witching Well do again? When it enters, it scries, and then you can sack it to draw 2.
Scry again, I think, and then draw a card or something like that. No, draw 2, yeah. It costs 4. I don't think we need that.
But 4 for 2 cards is not too bad.
I don't think we need that right now. It's very slow and it costs your card early, it's Christ, but we have the card draw effects and we have the counter effects, and I guess we'll play some of them, but not all of them. Let's also put that here for now and that one. And the rampy cards. We have a lot of rampy cards. Cruder is a lot of value.
I like the Apex art design.
Yeah, same. It's like, basically you can fight. You have to fight.
Yeah, you have to fight until it dies, or up until to there's no creatures anymore.
It says up to one, okay.
Ah, okay.
You don't have to.
Okay, so it basically deals 10 damage divided every one of opponent's creatures.
You don't need to sacrifice it. You can just fight for however much you want.
And it deals 10 to as many as it can before it.
But you don't have to make it die.
Yeah, but until you stop. You can't fight more than it survives.
Yeah. I think this probably gonna need to cut some. Yo, what's up, Yar? Wobble says he loves you. Tell him I love him back, of course.
That's fearsome trade.
Sorry?
That's fearsome trade, is it?
Yeah, it ramps you 3 times. But it's probably the weakest of the the ramp cards we got. I mean, it does make mana of any color. So which of these do you wanna play? It's like four more cards. I think Memory Lapse is very good.
Why is the Barin not the consideration?
He is, but having double blue on 3 is kinda hard in this deck, I think. We only have one fixer here, and the Incubation Druid. So I said you're basically fixing you for double blue, but I think I want... So from these cards, let's move them. No, this is gonna screw up my piles. from these 10 we want 5 cards, I think.
I guess we want the Memory Lapse since it's single blue.
Mm-hmm.
And the Scour.
So this and this one.
Yeah, exactly. I would also take the 6 mana draw 4.
Yeah, this also cycles for 1 and then Scour costs 2. And then 2 more.
I still kind of like the Witching Well.
Something to do on turn 1, I guess. But it does cost you a card.
Yeah, but it replaces itself once you have the 4 mana.
Mm-hmm. Maybe this and this. Cut these 4. No, still 1 cut. I put 1 too many.
Probably dismissed.
It's very good though. I'd rather cut the Witching Well, I'm not a fan.
But when do we have 4 mana open?
Sometimes. Yeah, good question. Yeah, I'm gonna try it like this. Oh man. I still haven't mastered the art of Magic Online sorting, but okay, here we are. So blue is sort of not that big. We could take out all the double blue cards if we want to and put in something else. I do like Pondering Mage, but then our mana is a lot easier.
What about the Primordial Mist? Maybe that's good.
Primordial Mist. Yeah, could be. It's like, make a 2-2 every turn. It doesn't die to creature removal like that other thing in green does. Do you know what I mean?
Like
the card that does the same thing, except it's a 4-4. I'm also not sure if we're even gonna have the blue on turn 1, maybe another green card.
I don't think we have it on turn 1.
Yeah, but then it's kind of a blank in the opening hand. Maybe we do want the other ramp card just like this. But now do we have enough mana sinks, or do we just ramp into nothing? We have this thing. We could play this or Spectral Sailor.
How many lands are you planning to play?
17, including these two.
Even though we have so many ramp cards.
16 is a possibility.
How many cards do we have to ramp?
Listen, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
10, yeah. I think I'll do 16, try it and see whether it works out. I really don't like the Fiddler mage.
I do like it actually.
I just don't think that wins us the game if we spend turn 3 to play a 2-2 and then on turn 4 play a Mana Rock. That doesn't sound great to me.
A 2-2 is better than you might think. I feel like. What else would you play? Sup, bros?
The Witching Well.
The Witching Well. Okay, maybe. I'm not sure. What is tier 0 right now? I have no idea. This is a new cube. I've never played this format before. The amount of things, rather. What are you trying to say? yeah. Alright, let's try it like this. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 blue cards. This cycle is for colorless. So it's like a 10-6 split or something like that. So this is already forest. This gets you. If we go like this, we have 10 green. Seems like a plan. 15 lands, but there's also this one. Yartar spreading misinformation. I don't think he said anything. That's 6, 7, no, there's gotta be more. 8, 9, 10. And some. This one cycles, I guess. Yeah, we have like 10. Watch him roll. Alright, let's play. And just hope we don't get stomped by aggro decks. If we can get our ramp on and play our big things, we might win the game.
One thing I just was thinking is if we have the feeling that it's too few lands, we can add one more because we have the one land that can be used in this battle.
Yeah. Maybe it's fine. We need like two lands and a bunch of ramp. My hair looks moist and squeaky clean. Yeah, I just washed it and it is in fact still very greasy because that's what you do with hair like this. So I'm glad you noticed. Where you get these remixes, lol. YouTube channel called Silver Gunner. They are amazing. Actually amazing. Is your hair from Greece? Yes. Alright, round 1 of Negative Cube on the play versus EQ16, what's up? We have the perfect hand, but actually with Spear of the Suns, I might just keep it. Turn 2 Sphere, turn 3 Overgrowth, if we find the land, also the Druid, I'm gonna keep it. Maybe Lugia here can be ingredient for a Gyro. What is a Gyro? Thriving Isle naming green. These lands are pretty cool actually. Okay, we find the forest, so I guess we play the Druid now.
Fine.
Because this only taps 3 times for mana.
But still you use 1 mana less than.
But if I tap the Druid next turn, I would already remove a counter from the sphere. So I guess I wanna get the repeatable thing out first, right? Opponent's green blue, so it's probably not dying. Okay, they're also red. Bolt incoming, Bolt the bird, no. Daring Saboteur. Can't be blocked and they can loot. I'm okay with this.
Yeah,
I had overgrowth on the island. Probably on the forest, because we wanna keep up that blue sometimes. Oh no, I think we removed all of them. Okay, which one did I... Okay, tap first so I don't accidentally tap the land I enchant. Yeah, that's 3.
You could play the Lisa here even.
Yeah, but she gets attacked.
Yeah, she gets attacked, yeah. I mean, she does go to 3.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we can't Altisaur next turn. But I'm still gonna play that thing. Guys, that's a lot of text. What are you writing? Like a burrito apparently from Greece, attack model Wait, Overgrowth use Frenzy Plant powered by Overgrowth plus Stab, you're dead. Yeah, what Yar said. Exactly what Yar said. What's the opponent doing? I'm just getting my ramp on here and I'm loving it. Am I dead or you're dead? You're the one whose YouTube channel says I'm dead, so I think it's you. See, I code the meta. Opponent's all the colors. Except green. No, except black. Core Hookmaster. Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Core Hookmaster.
Ah.
I'm gonna play my dragon. And that's that. If we find the land, we Altisaur them. And they're gonna be sad, hopefully. You're Unge, that's what you are. Bro, why do you keep saying that? And no one has any idea what you're talking about. Like, literally nobody knows what that is. And you don't wanna tell us. Dude, they are soul herdering, I love it. Also, we gotta get rid of that. Now it's gonna take us probably a bit longer. Let's see what they tap though. Probably that thing, because otherwise it destroys shit, right? Alright, land into Altisaur, let's go! And raise Forerunners. So that doesn't really do that much, it attacks for...
We can play that time. And it's trampling.
Yeah. Could also just Nissa. Well, it's a big thing.
You can play this attack and then next turn, if you don't draw the land, you can just ultimate Nissa right away and attack for a bunch.
Oh, that's sick. Untap two lands and they become 5/5.
Basically 10 damage for each mana.
Yeah, this is also still a 7/7 if... Like, usually with Credo if you wanna kill them right away, but... This is still a 7/7 when it sticks around. And we attack for 9 here, I guess. Oh, it says other creatures. Alright. The opponent's under a lot of pressure. They're soul herdering, but it's not like they're drawing extra cards and... Or have a creature that kills something. Maybe they play a... Well, Flametongue Kabo can't be in the cube. Did we see any creatures in the opponent's colors that could kill something? Maybe a bounce? A Manowar type effect would be pretty sick. Opponent has Scar. Sometimes I'd like just playing big things and say, opponent, can you answer my big things? But yeah, say they have a creature that bounces something, I think that would be their best part here. Right. Okay, plays a land. Manowar. Is Manowar in the cube? Probably not.
Nah, Manowar is in other cubes.
Yeah. Is it? I have no idea. Which one? Like, it's only the ones that are on Magic Online. Not like every cube that has ever existed.
Nah, I get that, but...
Is it in the Pauper cube? Is it a Pauper card?
Legacy cube, it's gotta be in there somewhere.
Yeah.
It's a classic.
Alright, so if we play the Nissa for... Like, we can give up on her and make 2 5/5 flyers.
Are they flying?
I think so. Yeah, flying and haste.
Really dead? 5, 10, 17, and they can block.
They can one, block only like 6 power.
But their creatures all die.
They would, yeah, let's do it. Here come my things. See what they do. We can get Nissa back with Green Warden if we want to. It's pretty nice.
We needed to get something in the graveyard anyways.
It was all planned. Opponent is thinking.
If they don't have anything, they need to block with a soul herder.
Yep. Dude, that thing is Vigilance. Green creatures have all the abilities all the time. They actually have to make the multi-block here. and everything fucking dies. Nice. Good trade. You're dead too. And I still have my health card and two good cards in my hand. Yeah, taking the ramp cards is always a good idea. Alright, so what is the opponent doing? The Bunt Blink deck, I guess, with the red splash.
One more land. Now that I realized we have the one land that can act as a spell as well.
I mean, that really the deck does want a lot of mana. See that.
Yeah, or the whale. If you don't like the whale.
Just put a land instead of the whale. I guess that's a keep. That is not the fastest hand ever, but it does things. No ramp is actually kind of funny. The deck has 10 ramp cards. Do I cycle the thing on one here?
I don't.
See what we draw. Yeah, I want to play this on turn 2, so I gotta play the expense anyway. Well, we have the card draw. Was kinda nice. Alright, yield until end step. If they destroy my land, I'm sad, but that's not a thing that it can happen. Imagine if I clicked island here. Yeah, let's just play the grizzly bear. Born in with the soul herder deck, I love it. It's awesome. And already transforming, nice. You never see this thing transformed in modern, but you never see him anyway, anymore anyway.
What does it do? These spells cost one less. We got it.
Oh yeah, I can still scar, yeah. Nice. I didn't even know that had that thing. It's also a ramp card. I didn't even realize. I don't think I want the forest.
Nah, I don't think so either.
Bottom, top. Attack you for 3? Dude, this card is pretty good. I didn't even realize. Did I play 2 spells? No!
Yeah, it's fine.
It is fine. It's good on both sides. Dude, absolute banger incoming. Actually, Gragwuth, aka Marco, showed me this song in the stream once. Opponent's not playing anything! Do they have like...
They prefer the flipped version of the
In these types of situations I wanna just like not play my things. I could play the path.
You need to play the path.
But they're obviously holding up... I could just end step Illumination. They're obviously holding up Counter Magic, right? Yo, what up Skywalker?
They didn't count anything faster.
Yeah, maybe they have the 4 mana counter draw card thing. I feel like I would just wanna pass here. Like, they gotta make a move. It's not me who has to make the move here. I could do this. No, I wanna do this instead. See? Now they lost 4 mana.
They might have done so regardless.
No, they're obviously holding a counter spell. Maybe they only have green mana, but... Bro momento! Thank you for the sub, Skywalker!
Umbro momento.
I mean, I don't know who you are.
Umbro momento.
What the fuck is that?
It's pro momento. For the holy Shoba. I'm actually not sure who Skywalker is, but it's gotta be one of the homies. Weasel JCD, thank you for the follow. I'm gonna play the Tasker and attack if they don't counter. Oh yeah. So I can still play the Druid. No, I need double green.
Yeah, but you can
answer. But do I wanna attack? Let's see what happens.
Yeah, let's see what they do.
See? They did have the counter spell.
You don't know whether they did last turn.
Sure they did. I'm very sure they did. I'm double spelling, but getting my ramp on. Also, this is sort of a mana sink slash another aggression. Like, you don't just keep a hand with no spells. I'm very sure they had that counter spell. Yeah, take that land damage, opponent. Linvala the Preserver. You gain 5 life and get a 3-3 angel token. At some point we're gonna fight your board dead. Can we already do it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and it costs 8, right? No, yeah. they played a thing. We would have to have that flipped. Alright, we have mana. At this point, do I cycle that? I kinda want to cycle it. I have so many lands anyway.
Yeah, you can if you want.
I also have Scour. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 mana. I don't want to play the Druid.
We can Druid and Scour and cycle. Can we do it all?
No. I could adapt and play the Druid, just get all my mana on.
You can't do it, Scour and cycle.
No, that's 8. We only have 7 mana.
We have 8.
Oh yeah, that also makes mana. Alright, perfect. Could still adapt instead of playing Scour, the possibilities.
Then how much mana does it make?
It makes more than actually.
So if we use 5...
Two, three, four. At this point I'm cycling this.
Yeah.
Almost. Almost. Okay, can't do anything else. Passing and then hoping they don't have counter magic for the thing. How sick would a memory lapse here be? Well, now we're gonna wreck the bot. I think we keep the 10-10 and keep the 3-3 around. Or the angel, so we can attack. There's the memory lapse. One dude, one too deep in the deck. Alright, that's exactly enough mana, right? Here come the big things.
I think we keep the golem alive, right?
Well, if we keep the angel alive, we get to attack
but
for 2.
We can't block the angel. And we are under more pressure. Or we are at the lower life total at least.
No, I actually wanted to fight the angel. Well, now... I'm keeping the 10-10 though.
Yeah, keep the 10-10. And attack them.
It's Banjo-Kazooie music.
No, it's
yeah, you see, it says it right here.
No.
They're gonna misspeak. They wanted to kill the angel, but it's fine. They don't wanna attack into the 10-10, do they?
Please keep that I can.
It's only 1 minute long. You will live.
This is really a consideration every time for me to join you here. Honestly.
It's 1 minute.
Yeah, but there's so many of those 1 minutes.
Yo, drawing cards. Nice. Are they dead? Like, this is a lot of power, right?
It is. I need a second queen. Third queen, I mean.
We got it. Alright. 4, 7, 19, 26. Yeah, they're dead. Holy Shoba, I still wanna know who Skywalker is. Maybe Leedy.
Yeah, I was thinking that.
Opponent is still making blocks, I mean. Yeah, E4 effort. Yo, we ramped them. We totally ramped them.
Even the small brother of the behemoth does its job.
I'm not sure if we want the 17th land or no.
Yeah, I'm also not sure.
Yeah, I'm gonna do it just because if we don't have the blue, the well is annoying. If we do have the blue, it can find us the land, right? But it's not really required. I think the way these games played out, we had our mana and our value and our card draw.
This deck can attack for a lot of damage out of nowhere with the Nissa and with the Forerunners.
Yeah, this is amazing, and we even have the pseudo board wipe also here. Isu and subscribers pog. Oh, you wrote that earlier. Yep, Isu and subscribers. Wait, I'm not even searching for a match. I thought I was, but I only clicked save tag. And I'm not. I was gonna say I'm getting a drink, but we already got that. The next match. Alrighty. Round 2 versus BLC1 on the draw. What's up? Yeah, ramp spell on turn 3 into... I think I'm keeping this. It's very slow on the draw though. This hand needs help. Let's mulligan it. We're gonna get something better, right? This is faster. Green, blue. So I'm gonna put away one of the two drops. It's either sphere or Milliken. Milliken dies to removal.
Still, I think it's better. There's not that much removal in this cube, I think.
Yeah, no, there's a lot. Just green, blue, white doesn't really have it, but red and black has.
I still think it doesn't really want the...
Yeah, we have the colors. Many times 3 is enough, but... I mean, Milliken could tap for 0, so... see, red... I already smell bad things.
It's fine.
Blend is good. And if they remove our things, it just slows us down a bit. I wanna stick the mist. Like, it's a lot of value. Dark Dweller Oracle. I mean, the creature has summoning sickness. So if you play it next turn, it doesn't make mana right away. Does that make a difference? Probably not. Wait, let's play that. Looking like we have a more aggressive opponent this time. Rayaf Mastersmith. They don't have the land though. When a creature that's equipped attacks, it gets double strike. That is crazy. Alright, Arctisaur is here. Do I trade off the recruiter if it's possible? I think I do.
I think so too.
Right, can they flash in? Is Maul of the Skyclave a flash equipment? It's not, right? Not that I get got here. But, oh no, wait, that doesn't work. When it attacks, no, that's it, yeah. Okay, now we're blocking. See if this is a trade, okay? Dude, I like that actually. Akiri Fearless Voyager. When you attack with an equipped creature, you draw a card. You can unattach something and it gets indestructible. Pretty cool. And we're missing. That should be pretty good against the 2-2 deck, hopefully.
They have a 3-3 though.
They do. And we got an overgrowth, so we can exile it and then play. That's pretty nice. You can play your lands if you want to. So if you jump block, you can know it says this turn, so I'm just gonna try to trade this off here.
Yeah.
Alright, now just running lands to cast my things, maybe. Or a migration path or something. Okay, opponent missing their equipment payoffs. Fireblade Charger. If his equipped is haste, and when he dies, he deals damage equal his power. There's a lot of good payoffs for equipment here. I just need some.
We have the bigger thing currently, at least.
I mill my lands, but I still draw my lands, that's pretty cool. And we have running value. Maybe we're gonna mill ourselves with Milliken.
Milliken is milling, I didn't even think about that.
Yeah, it mills you.
What's under the manifest?
Yes, sir. Yo, we win! they just didn't find their lands or their equipment. Like, they had the third land on turn 4 and then didn't find the fourth on turn 6 or something. That's kind of annoying. So we are up against more of a aggressive slash equipment. Like, do we have any? Not really anything that kills equipment. Whoops, what did I just add? I accidentally double clicked something. Cranial plating, no thank you. So we might want some. We don't really have anything anyway. I think we're fine. Cards that are rather slow. Even the mist was good here. Bunken Cycle. Yeah, I think we're okay. Just try to be. If they find their equipment, they have a sick synergy deck. Now I wish we had that 5 drop that destroys an artifact. But we took another ramp card over it, which I can't really regret. It's a good hand, I think.
Yeah.
If we get to the Artisaur, hopefully, somehow.
Do we want to play the recovery as a land here?
We have 3 lands, so this is what we draw, but Kruder. I'm gonna go with no. But
that might
we can still play it on turn 4, right?
Yeah.
Boast makes it 2-1 for 3 mana. It's pretty cool.
Are we doing?
So they can attack us for 2 and make it 2-1. We could play the Recruiter if we drew it and then path. It's probably better. I think we're just trying to outrace them with our ramp, maybe.
If they spent the whole turn making a 2-1, it's not the worst at least.
I agree. The scarier things they could be doing. Yo, there's Ash Barons in the cube. I like this card. It's pretty cool. They did the thing. And we might give them another chance to do another thing.
Yeah.
Because I do want to path here.
Yeah. I can see.
Path means 4, 5, 6, 7 mana next turn. Well, we still gotta do it, kinda.
Is there something like a phone book where I can look up an account name here and see who's behind it?
I don't know any of these people, so no.
I wonder who that Skywalker guy
is. Same. At the beginning of your upkeep, exile the top card. If it's a non-land card, you may cast it, and when you cast a third spell, it transforms, and then it's a Lightning Bolt thing. Okay, that's pretty slow. Green Warden of Murasa. We can play that. Super Smash Brothers.
What if we adapt here? Then we have 4 mana, right?
4, 5. No, 3, 4, yeah.
So we could Duskwatch Recruiter. That's not great.
I think the 5-4 is better. We're already at 14.
Yeah, I agree.
Get the thing back that we can cycle if we want to. Value. And pass.
So if they cast 3 spells in one turn, it transforms.
Yep. Slaying Fire. 3 damage, and if they pay 3 red, it deals 4. Okay, so I can exile it and get nothing. So I'm not gonna do that.
Step back, I'm the OG, EM, New Age, classic, big body.
And we just got to get to this artisan. We have 8 mana. So I guess we just cast Recruiter and Path and Adept.
What if we adapt? How much lands do we have? 7 lands?
Yeah, let's adapt. Play the expanse. No, just adapt and recruiter, and the next turn we can use this thing to cast Artisar.
If it survives.
Yeah. We kinda have to count on that, right?
Unless we play the migration path, right?
Yeah, but I don't wanna count on not dying if all my creatures are tapped. Mm-hmm. They played one removal spell, we haven't seen any other, so let's just do it this way. Question is if we should block with the druid, see what they do. Dude, it feels like our deck is just setting up its combo until it plays its big thing and wins the game. I love it. Water. Champion's Helm, +2/+2. And when it's legendary, it has hexproof. Okay. They have 1 mana open. Do I take 4? Double strike. Okay, I'm jumping, I think. It also has hexproof, but I don't want to go to 2. So, yeah. Now we're gonna play our 10-10.
At least a 10-10 is still bigger than a 4-4 double strike.
They play. What happened?
Okay.
Yeah, that's fine. We kill the board and have a 10-10. They have. No, this. Now has nothing has hexproof. We kill everything. This makes how many mana? 3. So if overgrowth.
And we can kill everything without even our dinosaur dying.
So if overgrowth, that's basically down 1 mana. But I have 9, so I can't do that.
You have 1 more, right?
Yeah, so. But if I play overgrowth, I'm down to 6, up to 8, but then I can't do it. So
you're down to 6, but you get 3 again with a 2/+1, right?
Yeah. Yeah, true. Okay. So I chant here, then get down 3 and 3 again. Yeah, sure. Okay. Alright. In before Mana Tithe or something.
This is such a fun card.
Yeah, it's awesome. Holy shit. And by fun we mean not fun for the opponent.
Kill your board, get a 10-10.
Opponents shouldn't have re-equipped, but how could they know?
Yeah.
Man.
That was fun.
I feel like our deck's pretty good. What is that? Oh, it actually dies. I forgot about the charge ability, but I guess it's fine.
We can get it back.
True.
Or you can get the green warden back and then with that get back the
other. Oh yeah,
thing.
True. Alright. But don't yield, I wanna crack my thing. Why do we wait until our end step to activate our tap fetch lands? Just something people do, but. So this card is coming in clutch here now. Because. Cast.
Yeah, we take the green one, right?
I pay 3 and then I have 6, 7. Yeah, then I can keep my 3/5 untapped and have a 5/4. Thing is gonna be a problem though, but I can't cast I can cast Altisaur. Yeah, let's not get greedy and just kill everything. I think that's better. Here we go again, we go killing again. Because if we kill this first, we can even kill everything again. Wait, I should have killed that first, but it doesn't matter. This card is busted. Bro, like killing the bot twice, that's wild. Whenever one or more creatures attack one of your opponents or planeswalker they control. So that's worded so weirdly because it's a multiplayer card, yeah. I guess, right?
Yeah. Do we cycle that?
Yeah, sure. Alright, so we can draw and not attack. First strike, vigilance, trample and haste. So we're gonna have to double block that, right? So it's, if it goes through it deals 8, if I read this right, so we can't have to stay back. So let's play that.
I mean, we could take 8 and kill them on the backswing.
Yeah, but if they draw a shock effect, it's pretty bad. Oh yeah, true. Stop what you're doing. Stop the peek and show it. I'm here to hit y'all with an electric boogaloo. The girls say I'm shouting, of course they would know. Let's play the Hellcat.
Maybe we do want to attack here.
Mm.
We kill them next turn.
Yeah, true, and we take 8, right? There's no like double strike here. First strike, vigilance, trample and haste, +2/+2, Angels, has proof, menace. Alright, let's do it this way. Have the memory lapse up. They have 3 damage to any target. So, if they have something else of their draw, we dead, I think. A tense situation here.
Yeah.
These equipment things are really strong. Wait, they only have 3 mana though, so I think we're fine.
Yeah.
They did flip a vault effect though. Sorcery, speed. So this gets all of the abilities. We can't block. I just can't misclick now on countering the thing. If they have like, there's Galvanic Blast in the cube. If they have also that, okay, they have land. Good. Man. Very nice. They can block still, right? No, we can destroy the thing with the golem. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain, Raptin, who be burning up tracks like a fresh combatant, trying to challenge the falcon for the top of the pile. Dude, the king of evil's even jocking my style. Now you show me. I like mana. Dude,
nice.
Good match. We are 4-0. This is going pretty well.
those decks are always so fun.
Right now though, I'm gonna get a drink, and you can click join if it fails.
Yeah, and I think we have a mulligan.
And we are on the play with all the payoffs and 1 memory lapse, yeah. And on the play versus Drew Burry. So, yeah, that's way better. Do we ship just a blue card? There's no blue mana here. I think that's fine. Then we can ramp hard and play Meteor Golem. Yeah. Destroy something. Right. Dude, I couldn't find a glass for my beer.
Oh no.
Do you have both of my glasses?
No.
Where's the second one? Ah, it's probably in the dishwasher. But it's done, right? Right, I'm getting it. Alright, look at this. In the finals, we are up against another ramp deck. It's obviously the busted archetype. And I swear I pressed F6 before I left, but what you gonna do, right? Dude, we're ramping hard. Almost looking like my vintage cube decks. Like, look at this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 mana already. Alright. We got some good stuff. Look at this. Stiegelbier Zwickel. Cheers everybody. Whomst ever may be watching here. Alright, land. Yo, Gideon's Lawkeeper though. Land.
We are playing humans.
One's playing the humans deck. Do I kill non-land permanent?
Okay.
That would be kinda wild if that could destroy lands. So we do play the thing, right? We have no blue mana, so we gotta hope to find something, honestly.
Yeah.
We could kill one of those and have a 3-3.
What does the Maya flip into?
At the beginning of your end step, create a wolf. Yeah, I think I'm gonna kill that, because if that happens, it's pretty good. The Lawkeeper is also nice, but... yeah, this is scary. We have nothing, and if this gets going, and then we get pumped. Right. We're gonna need blue mana and card draw, or just one of our big green things, I guess. Flying. When it attacks, you can exile another creature and then return it. Pretty good. Opponent's got the whole... I'm gonna just attack with my 3-3. Like, I can't block that, and they're probably gonna take the 3 anyway. And if it kills something else, that's also fine.
All the ramp.
Yeah. Okay, we have mana. Now actually the Forerunner would be pretty sick, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Well, we'd have to tap two of our creatures.
Oh, that thing is cool.
Makes 2/2/2s and cruise for 4 and then... yo, holy shit, that's gonna explode.
Oh, it makes another 2/2/2s.
Does that thing have haste? No.
No.
Oh, they blinked a creature and then they get it back. Dude, that's sick. We are in need of help. Well, we have blue mana. So that's something. They have counter magic there. No, they can't have. They can't even have, don't even have mana. Yeah, I got nothing.
Yeah. So opponent isn't really ramping, but
no.
Playing some sweet stuff.
Wild Growth is just a really good card. we have our blue mana now, so basically any of our big payoffs does it.
I know we'll draw a land or a ramp card.
I mean, that's the downside of a deck like this, right? Yeah. It's full of air. Maybe we shouldn't have kept this, but we had 1/7 drop.
Yeah.
Probably gonna draw the double blue card now. Can we kill this somehow? Yes, we gotta try, right? Rock with the 1/2 and the 3/3. Wait, what? Oh, they blinked it again, obviously. That's pretty sick. Like, they make 3 cards every turn. Ronas. Yeah, opponent has the Ronas deck. Alright, we need something now or we're dead. We're probably dead anyway. That's good. But not good enough, I think.
Nah, I don't think so either.
Opponent's got the 6 synergies going. Right, we're not even in a position to attack, right?
When 9 power for 5 mana isn't good enough.
Yup. It happens. but only in the finals of the negative cube draft. Negative space cube. Space cube. Honestly, if that thing didn't have flying, we'd not be in such big trouble. Well, Ronos is also gonna be very annoying. He doesn't attack though. What? Can he could attack, right? Okay. Like, they are only generating cats. I guess what we need is, if we draw a dino, we can kill five. Well, this and some other things, I guess, but. Gone is taking it slow. Why did Jonas not attack? They must have missed it, right? Well, that just gets blanked by the lawkeeper, sadly. If I could go through, we could just go zero, everything dies. Maybe they miss it. You never know. You gotta give your opponent a chance to mess up, right? Sick deck though. The green-white, go-white strategy is also one of my favorites. Opponent confirmed not missing the thing. Well, maybe they will miss it before we can attack. Maybe we just die here. They go in with all, we might be dead. Ah. Equipped creature is Death Touch and Lifelink. Yeah, that's not the least of my problems right now. Opponent has... Yo. Look, well, you know what's funny? Both players have drawn three lands. And everybody has a lot of shit in play. They're still not going in with Ronas. He has Indestructible and Death Touch. Okay. I guess they just wanna keep making kitties. They didn't blink this time. Okay. What? Did they not blink anything or did I miss something? What's coming back here? Nothing. Opponent! Okay, they're not missing it. I feel like we could already be dead though.
Yeah, definitely. If they just attack with all the tutus all the time.
Alright, we have double blue. We can draw four cards. Basically, what got us into this trouble is the cat card. Loving it.
Yeah, that chariot is a really sweet card.
Especially with the whole blinking shenanigans. Alright, they gotta kill us here.
It's basically just by itself already 8 power for 4 mana.
Yeah. I mean, kinda. You have to crew it for 4, right?
Yeah, but it, still, if the vehicle trades off with another 4, you still have the 2/2s.
I haven't done the math, so I'm blocking, but I think we are probably dead here. Yeah, we're at 8. That definitely kills us. Wanna make some sketchy choices, but I guess it just didn't matter. They were pretty fired. Do we wanna bring in some counter spells? Probably not. Well, the double blue is sorta not the best. We just gotta find our stuff.
Yeah.
We did have kinda a lot of time here. If we find something, maybe. Yeah. They gave us more time than they needed. Okay, we do have our blue mana. I guess I'm gonna keep this on the play. Do I cycle my thing on the first turn? See, I don't. I might just need all my mana the next two turns. Yo, this is a one drop? Okay, so really good. I love it. I'm gonna cycle it. Another cycle card. Fleecemane Lion.
Nice.
Very nice. Also very annoying for Hanissa. Didn't tap my... Oh, they don't have mana. Wait, what? Oh, yeah. 4 mana. I don't really want to play Nissa.
Maybe it's just the illumination.
Yeah, maybe. One, two, three, four, five, six. So we can't golem next turn. Yeah, let's draw. Let's draw some cards. Yield until end step because I got nothing. Not sure if that's slightly unoptimal because I'm not really bluffing counter magic.
Take your mana thing when you can't draw anymore.
Alright, oh, kinda true. So maybe I shouldn't do that. I honestly got by that a few times already in the past. I just like saving time. Wait, I mean, doesn't that do of any type that a land you control could produce? Oh, that's bad. I didn't know that.
That was not a good turn.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, we should read our cards.
Kinda. So it also does that when 3 mana of that type, yeah. I didn't know that. To anyone who may be watching, yeah. I mean, I guess that's normal. Nobody knows all the cards in this cube. So the Gale Powder Mage is back.
Maybe that's the reason to play one more island instead of the forest.
So I could block here, but then I can't. Then I can't golem next turn. I'm gonna just take it. They don't have the craziest things going here right now, so that's something.
The flyer, right?
Yeah. Wait, when did they play Ronas? I kind of missed that.
Last turn?
Didn't they play the flyer last turn? Or was that the turn before?
I'm not sure.
I get confused. Other humans get +1/+1. No, there's one human, okay. I taps the thing and attacks for 5. I almost thought they attacked for 10 here. So a land gets us to a 7/7, but we'd have to tap our mana dogs and probably die. But what else can we do, right?
We do get Vigilance.
Yeah, but we do have to tap these two, and yeah. They have to tap her. It's not the best.
Yeah.
So they can tap one thing, and we... And then they activate Ronas, and we're dead, right? They don't even need to play anything.
Nah.
They're not gonna do it again. We're actually not straight up dead to that. Blocks... No, when they tap here... Give Ronas trample or something else trample. We're so dead, right? I think we're dead on board.
We'll see.
Math is for the client, we're just sitting here. I wanna play this card next time. I'm just gonna take Gideon's Lawkeeper. I love these cards. Thopter Arrest. Alright, I mean that also works. And you could just attack with Ronas. They haven't really done that ever. Did they tap my thing here? I'm still not dead, right? I love it. Opponent really has a lot of chill. You gotta love it. I could have adapted, but then my creatures are tapped again.
They only want to win when they really want to win for real.
Yeah, true. They still don't have my blue mana. So, this is one non-blue source, if you don't have another. So basically none, because we don't play double blue cards. Yeah, the opponent doesn't like going for the win. It's amazing. I got a song that I'm sure you're gonna like. It's a really good one. And one of these is they just wanna play the game, they don't wanna win yet. I love it. It's a basic land. Human Scout. They tapped the thing, but then they didn't attack. Cool. Alright, can we Nissa them to death? I think we can.
Yeah. They don't have a flyer, do they? We take for 10 in the air.
Oh man, opponent.
Make sure you have enough mana for this.
I'm even gonna use one more so I can keep her around just in case, I guess. Doesn't really matter. Wait, I paid way too much. It's just never using. No, it, oh, this makes 3 now. Cancel!
You tap the Milliken, you can't cancel.
Usually you can. Oh, because I get information. Alright, whatever. I'll just use everything. I could cycle my thing, but no. Like, X is 8. Alright, I have two 5/5 creatures flying. You tapped your tapper. And we win! The opponent doesn't even care about winning. They just want to play the game. You gotta admire it.
One question, since they are pretty fast, maybe more islands and maybe Barin is in.
Mm-hmm. Does that help? Is the question, or do we just have to out-ramp them? Like, what would we cut? If we cut ramp cards, it's not really. Is it a good idea? I don't know. Maybe some of the bad ones, but they are still good, right? It's like, even if it's bad, it's good. Maybe the card draw spell. Cut this for dead and put in another island instead of a forest. We do still have
one more island enough for the Barins. The question is, do we not make the Barins switch?
Good question. We could instead play, what, a 4-1? A 2-2?
Maybe the 4-1 should be in against this deck. I mean, they do have the tapper, that's not great.
Target of spell or ability. Yeah. I think we're just staying course.
Yeah.
We do need some sort of card draw to make up for
I would have made the island swap anyways.
So this is 9. 10 green sources. We need one in our opening hand, I guess. I really don't want to go down to 9 though. No, it's fine. We have a lot of blue. We just kept the hand based on misinformation. Dude, but this song, it's so good. Alright, we have blue, green and cards to play. I'm keeping this. Dude, you gotta love it. Crawling Barons. Nice.
Did you program these commands yourself that it knows when you type in Doom what it needs to do?
Yeah. You can just enter any text, but since there is a song request command, you can use enter the text for the song request command for the command, if you know what I mean. So there's no way they're not gonna play a spell, right? I'd rather play my ramp dog.
Yeah.
Did you get what I meant?
Yeah.
It's pretty amazing. MTG bot is such a good piece of software. Shoutouts to whoever programmed it. Hanged Executioner makes a 1/1 and can exile a creature. Well, 4 mana. Double strike, I'm not blocking here. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 mana on turn 3, it's pretty good. So I guess I'm playing my Tusker to have a body. And then Hellkite, can play Recruiter later. Yeah. It puts a counter on here so I can't adapt, yeah. But I have more mana. I think that's fine. I think that's what we want. Combo achieved of our first few picks, or at least first pack, we picked up these two. Elvish Visionary, nice. They have some sweet blinking synergies going in that deck. Also, they have the flyers now, so they can't die to a surprise Nissa. Dude, that was so good. But it was like I have all the time in the world, and then 1,
hey,
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Not quite, but almost. So next turn, I guess. We're just dumping our other things here. This is a pretty busted draw for our deck, honestly. I know you shouldn't play your shit post pre-combat, but do I attack with my 5-5?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do it. This is gonna be one of my favorite songs ever, it's so awesome. Like, I've never played Doom, but apparently the game Doom has music that sounds like this, a style. Alright, now give me my golem to destroy the Thopter Arrest. We're gonna do the Budweb shenanigans again, right?
Yeah.
Oh, now we got something else to do for later. Yeah, this deck is actually insane sometimes. And double strike doesn't matter, right? Yo, we win! Trophy! Let's fucking go! Opponents
I really
screwed themselves!
Last match.
To whoever may be watching this on YouTube, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in a few minutes for the next one.